You know, usually when I press the button, there we go. We're all set. Maybe that'll be the gift in the new year. Well, I will figure out how to do Zoom. We'll see. But welcome to Christmas Eve service. It is a pleasure to be together as God's family through Zion Spies Evangelical Lutheran Church. We have some good news right here, right off the top from Luke chapter 1, verse 26 to 38. God sent the angel Gabriel to visit a young woman. Her name was Mary. She was scared. She had never seen an angel before. Gabriel said, "Don't be afraid. You are very special to God. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son. You must name him Jesus. He will be called the Son of the Most High God." Mary asked, "How can it be so? I'm not married." Gabriel answered, "With God, all things are possible." Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for being with us now too. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for making each of us special with abilities and personalities chosen just right for each one of us. Help us to share, love, forgive, rejoice, and to give you thanks every day. Amen. Mary said in response to her conversation with the angel, "I love God. I will do what God has chosen me to do." May we also do what God has directed us towards. Our worship is in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. A reading from Luke chapter 2. Mary loved Joseph. Mary and Joseph were going to be married soon. Joseph lived in Nazareth, but his family lived in Bethlehem. And we get to listen to "O Little Town of Bethlehem," just one verse. I have the sound on. Thank you for your patience.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee.
So this is how Mary and Joseph got to that little town of Bethlehem. A new leader named Caesar ordered all the people to go back to their homeland. He wanted to count all the people in his kingdom. So Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem. Mary was going to have her baby soon. When they arrived in Bethlehem, they looked for a safe place to sleep, but all the inns were full. Finally, a man was able to help them. He said, "I do not have any rooms left, but you are welcome to sleep in the stable." Joseph made a warm place for Mary to rest. While they were there, little baby Jesus was born. We get to sing "Joy to the World."
Thank you.
Mary wrapped Jesus in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger. And so we sing, O come, all ye faithful, and remember all those that are gathered in to Jesus.
Joyful and triumphant, oh come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him.
Do come and adore him. At this part of the story, I'm going to stop for a moment and welcome you to unmute if you like, even turn on your cameras if you choose to do so. This is a time for a sermon and sharing as we talk about coming and adoring Jesus Christ, our Lord. So I know some of us got to share what's in our nativity sets on Sunday. And for me, I think one of the wonderful gifts of Christmas is not only the story of Jesus, but also the life of Jesus in the world. So I have a present next to me that I'm going to open right here. But I'm curious first, if any of you are excited about presents this time of year.
No. I like presents.
You like presents?
I do.
Okay.
I like to give them.
You like to give them. I'm hearing that too. Yes.
Me too.
And Mary too. Is that where you were going with that too, Greg?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, it is such a joy to be able to give a gift to somebody else. I prefer that myself. And maybe we're reflecting the love of God in the joy of giving gifts to other people, because God gave us the greatest gift of Jesus Christ. And you know how often gifts have maybe a little bit of wrapping paper on one side, maybe a card on another side. It seems to me that a card is a whole lot like the Bible. The Bible, when we open up the Bible and we look inside, there are images that come to mind. There are phrases that come to mind. Sometimes it's poetry. Sometimes it's a little bit of history. How many of you guys get Christmas cards that have people have written kind of what's going on for the whole year, just as a catch up kind of thing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I have that too. And that I think is a little bit of history, the highlights that people are willing to share and want to pass on and want to remember. And then sometimes people write things in handwriting too, just like special little notes. And we hear that sometimes in the New Testament. Paul especially will write little notes about his friends who are carrying the letter, or a special thanks to someone who's been important in the faith community. God has all those things wrapped up for us in the Holy Bible, the people to look out for, the people that are helpers, the people that are messengers, the people that are prophets, the people that are telling stories and history, the people that are singing songs. All that is written in the Bible, and that's a lot like the card. And then that's not all. I mean, the card is wonderful and the letters are fabulous. Sometimes there's a little bit more. Unfortunately, we're not in person, because what I'd like to do is give this to someone to open a gift themselves in church. But we're going to have to wait another season until we can be in church together. But sometimes people even rip open the gift and they pull it right out. And this is food. This is a fruit stolen from Mary and Delp. And it is so yummy. And there are wonderful things about the gift. But the reason I chose to open this one is that Jesus is like that. Sometimes Jesus is a wrapped gift that doesn't get unwrapped. Sometimes Jesus in our lives kind of sits like under a tree and is tantalizing and interesting, but we don't always get the opportunity to tear off the wrapper and to appreciate the gift inside. In this case, it's bread. Jesus is the bread of life. Jesus is that special nourishment that we have so frequently. Jesus is the one that is with us every day of our lives. In fact, so much so that sometimes we forget just how special he is. So I encourage all of us, whether we're opening gifts or giving gifts, whether we're eating bread or gluten-free bread or whatever we may be doing, to please celebrate the fact that Christ is the bread of life, and that God loves us so much that God gives us this remarkable gift of Jesus Christ to be in our lives, to nourish us, to bring comfort, to be a centerpiece of all that we do, not only ourselves when we're alone, but also as we gather as a community, sharing bread and feeding one another. So may you continue to be surprised by all the gifts, all the ways that Jesus is present in our lives today and tomorrow, and as we move forward in life, just like he's been present with us in the past and coming up until this point. Let us pray. Dear Lord God, thank you for your gifts of the word, of stories, of music, of friendship, of fellowship, of community. We thank you for the living word, Jesus Christ, who comes into our midst, who we celebrate today, who is the bread of life. Please continue to provoke us to get to know Jesus better, to take in these wonderful gifts into our lives, into our hearts, and to share that love, not only as we give gifts, but also as we go through daily life. In Jesus' name, amen. Hope you enjoy your gift giving and your gift receiving. On the night Jesus was born, shepherds were watching their sheep. Suddenly an angel stood before them and God's light shone all around. The angel said, "Do not be afraid. I bring joyful news to all people. Today in the town of Bethlehem, a Savior has been born. He is lying in a manger." Then a choir of angels appeared. They sang, "Glory to God in the highest, peace and goodwill to everyone on earth." The shepherds rushed to Bethlehem. There they found baby Jesus. They told Mary and Joseph what the angel said. We too get to celebrate the gift of life as we celebrate the birthday of Jesus. So some of you have Advent bags that we gave out at church a while ago. You might actually have glow sticks with you. Some of you might have candles with you. If the glow sticks have already been lit and enjoyed, good. That's all right too. But if you have a chance to light a candle around you, I see one of those Advent bags right there. That's cool. You can do that. We're going to sing Happy Birthday to Jesus, but I also found a song to dance to if we have any little ones who like to dance. Or big ones who like to dance.
I don't dance.
You don't dance. Okay. That's the gift of YouTube. And we're going to do the whole birthday song for Jesus. Ah, that's it, Terry. I'm glad you found it. All right. Martha and Terry, they're breaking their glow sticks. I don't know if you can see them. We almost have to turn out the lights. It's sunny enough, right? That's working well. So we'll sing Happy Birthday to Jesus. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jesus. Happy birthday to you. And many more. I like the celebration there in the household. And here's another version of a happy birthday. If Henry is anywhere close, he might enjoy this. May we too have a little fun with the good news of Jesus Christ's birth in our lives. I invite you to join with me now as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Just like the glow sticks and the candles and the lights all around us, our Eucharist, our communion, is also a light in the darkness. We eat together at the table. We eat believing that this meal remains powerful, that this meal reconciles, if only for a moment, all of God's creation, revealing that without exception, we are members of one body, the body of Christ, in endless diversity. Here at our tables sharing food, we are brought into the ongoing work of making creation whole. And so we begin our communion portion of worship. I invite you to make sure that you have bread and grape juice or bread and wine or some elements with you at this time. And welcome to those that are joining in now. The Lord be with you and also with you. We lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. Holy God, mighty Lord, gracious Father, endless is your mercy and eternal your reign. You have filled all creation with light and life. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. We praise you for the grace shown to your people in every age, the promise to Israel, the rescue from Egypt, the gift of the promised land, the words of the prophets, and at this end of all the ages, the gift of your Son, who proclaimed the good news in word and deed, and was obedient to your will, even to giving his life. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and gave all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." I invite you at this time to take the bread and to receive this as the body of Christ, given for you and for me. And to take the juice or the wine. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. Together, may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace, now and forevermore. Amen. As we savor this tasty promise of forgiveness, love, and grace, we listen to a rendition of the Lamb of God.
Meet Suvi, the magical all-in-one countertop kitchen robot.
Lamb of God.
peace from Krishna and from all of us as we celebrate this gift. So an additional blessing. May the body and blood of Emmanuel, God with us, strengthen us and keep us in his grace. God of blessing, at this table, at all these tables, we have seen you face to face. And in the gift of Christ's body and blood, our hearts have been refreshed. Send us now to shine with your goodness and bear witness to the one we have received, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. As the shepherds returned to their sheep, the shepherds told everyone what they had seen and heard. All along the way, the shepherds shouted praises to God. So I invite us, wherever we go, following worship and wherever we go in this whole new church year, that we too can tell people about the wonderful gift of Jesus Christ, and we too can shout praises to God. For now, we're going to sing Silent Night, Holy Night. So as those of you know who have been going with our Advent bags, this is one of the ways that the nativity scene could be created with the stickers. I hope you had a good time with the stickers and with the bags. And I wish you a Merry Christmas. Go in peace to share God's love. That we say thanks be to God. I have one more sending a piece of music. It's a little bit of We Wish You Merry Christmas, but please watch. It's a beautiful animation that also addresses very much some of the remarkable gifts of Christmas that we do give to one another and that you all have been giving all year. I've been noticing and appreciating the gifts of hospitality, the gifts of forgiveness, and the gifts of being together when we're able to do that. So please enjoy this little rendition of We Wish You Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you.
I hope you appreciated that beautiful little story before us all. May Christ continue to be a gift in your life and in our lives together as we go forward this Christmas, this whole Christmas season, and into this new year of 2022. God bless you.
Hmm.